What's up, everybody? Welcome to another Let's Play in the Titanfall 2 series right now for Supernova Games. I am here with my co-host of our weekly podcast, Mr. Joshua. How are you?
Good, how are you, Daniel?
I'm doing okay, man. I'm ready to fuck some kids up here, man. So let's get into some attrition. 780 in matches. We should be able to find a decent game here. It has been a while since I played this game, man. It's been like 2 weeks, and I cannot wait to get back into it. I love this game so much.
It's a good game, man. Criminally underrated.
Dude, freaking EA, like launching it right in between Battlefield and Call of Duty. Come on. It's so bullshit.
The article I'm writing for the site, I'm gonna be talking about EA and their management as it pertains to the article I'm writing.
Yeah, no, I mean, EA has done a really terrible job at, promoting the games that they should promote.
But I
And
mean,
it's really frustrating.
I get their approach they were trying to do, but just got those hardcore fanboys that will buy Call of Duty no matter what.
Yeah, I mean, like, we talked on the podcast a couple of weeks ago about Project Squirrel RPO and what we wanted to see from it. And one of the things that I had said was that we need to have something that entices us to play the game, well, not to play the game, but to buy the console itself. That there has to be some sort of like killer app that makes it worth spending the $500 to $600 that it is. And it, EA just, they do these things where they just kind of put games on the back burner, I feel. I mean, I deserve royalties for how much time that I put into marketing this game. I swear I do. I mean, for months,
You and Evangeline Gale.
dude, for months, me and him had the hashtag Titanfall 2 or hashtag buy Titanfall 2 for months to get people to buy it. And EA won't approve a it almost seems like they put it out there just to die, because EA's not going to approve a sequel to it and pay all the money to have the sequel to it if it just didn't sell well. And that's really shitty of them. Really fucking
Well, I
shitty.
mean,
It.
I think they'll approve a sequel, 'cause they already did a sequel to a game that didn't have that greatest sales numbers to begin with. The original Mirror's Edge,
That is true.
it took a couple of years, but we got a sequel to it, and depending on how you feel about it, opinions differ on that, on the sequel catalyst. But I mean, they still took a risk on doing it, man.
Right.
I can't knock them for that, but
Man, I'm really rusty. I've only got 9 attrition points. Oh,
all I can
boy.
say is, like, the way they handled it really, I guess you could say, left a void between them and Respawn.
Well, it was
Like
definitely kind of
Respawn,
like a it was definitely
they're
kind of
they
like a oh well, just deal with it. It's kind
yeah.
of like the response that they got. I mean, there was even a tweet that said that we're marketing Titanfall the way that we want to market it, and even Respawn chimed in, was like, whatever the fuck that means,
No, I think the one you're thinking of was they were saying, yeah, we would love to see a Titanfall 3 in That's when they said that.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's
like,
true.
That was no chill whatsoever.
No, and that it definitely put, you know, a strain on the business relationship between Respawn and EA. Which, I mean, after the first game, it was so anticipated, you know, with the movement and everything, and now with this game, what they finally got campaign going, and I mean, this game is criminally, like you said, underrated. I mean, it should be illegal what they did to this game.
Well, I mean, but you know, at the end of the day, though, like, I know Respawn is doing a Star Wars game for EA, so, and Respawn retains the rights to Titanfall. Because I remember that was the thing for Vincent Zampella, or how do you say his name?
Zampella,
yeah. That was like one of the things, like, you know, after the drama between them and Activision, you know, he was like, you know, I'm never not gonna own my own IP ever again or something. And they Respawn, you know, they own the rights to Titanfall, so they can take it elsewhere.
as they should. I mean, especially in this day and age, there was an episode of a podcast Unlocked a couple of weeks ago, and on one of the episodes, they actually talked about that, you know, developers didn't get the credit for a long time. No, actually, it was on IGN Unfiltered, and they had said that developers did not get the attention that they deserved, and finally they're starting to get that, where they're able to, you know, keep the IPs of the games that they're developing, you know, which in my mind, the developers are the people that, you know, make the publishers money, period. You know, like, they're the ones that are actually going to be putting in the, you know, effort to making the game great. You know, granted, you know, the publishers do all the marketing and stuff like that, but then you have the issue like what you have now, where the game is scrunched in between two first-person shooters that have fan bases that just will not quit, you know?
Yeah. You know, you got your people that will buy, you know, that buy their console, essentially, you know, just for that one sports game, and then Call of Duty.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, I have a friend like that, you know. I'm pretty sure you have a friend like that, that, mm-hmm. you know,
they buy Madden and Call of Duty. And that's it.
Yeah.
You know?
Which, I don't know how you can only play those games. Like, I would get so bored.
I think it's more like a time constraint than anything, really.
Yeah. I mean, I played a few games of Madden today, you know.
Oh, crap.
Only took me about half an hour.
Yeah. I remember the best team I ever had in Madden, I traded two first-round picks for Von Miller, and I traded two second-round picks and a third-round pick for Kuechly. So I had Miller, DeMarcus Ware, Kuechly, and then I had another really good linebacker, Sean Smith. Yeah, that was that was the best team that I ever had.
You know who's a linebacker I like? Like, he's somewhere in like that middle pack of like the best linebackers in the league. I really like Brian Cushing from Houston.
Yes.
And I know it's like really so good. Random, but like, he's good, but also like, I watched him on Hard Knocks, what was it, like 2 years ago when they did Houston, and just his personality was fucking hilarious.
He is really funny. So is Watt.
On that team, like, you have JJ Watt, that's like the face of the NFL. Like, you know, he's a good fun guy that, you know, that doesn't get in trouble and everybody, you know, likes. And then you have Brian Cushing, that's hilarious and just like a polar opposite because he's kind of an asshole, but it's hilarious.
Yeah, it really is. So I just did a nuclear ejection underneath the bridge. Yeah, that was fucking wonderful. Please feel free to laugh at me in the comments, because I deserve it.
Eric did that.
Okay, okay. Actually, Ian is on. Ian just signed on. Maybe we can try to get him in here. After this game, we'll try to get Ian in here. We'll do a makeshift podcast.
Yeah. You seen John Wick yet?
No, I want to. I really do. I loved your review of it, though.
Thanks. I was hesitant. Crap, that was a total fail. Because, you know, that was my first review from the site, and I'm like, I don't want to come out giving a 5 out of 5 out of the gate and having people be like, this
guy's just a homer.
You know, yeah.
This guy just doesn't want to be critical.
Yeah. He's one of those type of reviewers where he only gives out, you know, fucking...
Yeah, no, I mean, I've been hearing...
9s and 10s, yeah.
Well, I mean, one of those things that does happen too is, like, if I read a review and I see that, you know, somebody has given it, you know, like a 3, somebody else gave it like a 9, and somebody else gave it a 2 or like a 4, I'm like, yeah, you're just a homer. Like, you don't like speaking bad about things. You don't like critiquing things.
Yeah. And, you know, given the fact that it has universal critical praise and, you know, I'm not too worried about it, but, you know, if it would have been me giving, like, you know, just off the top of my head, if I would have gave Suicide Squad a 5 out of 5, I'm sure people would be like, what the hell?
Or, he's like, DVS or something.
Yeah. Although, I would have gave that a 9 out of 10, but we don't do 9 out of 10s.
No, we do.
That would have been a 4 out of 5.
We did do... 10-point scale, and then there was a poll that we did, and everyone wanted a 5-point scale, so that's kind of what we went to.
Yeah. I think it's the idea in your head that 4 could have been like, oh, well, you know, that could have been almost a 9, you know? Like.
Yeah. I'm going to back out of this room, and I'm going to see if Ian wants to get in here. Yeah. Let's see. If Ian wants to come in here. Ooh, I unlocked new shit. Ian Jones, we are doing a Let's Play for Titanfall 2. What's going on, buddy? Oh, you sound exhausted.
What's going on, man?
Make sure your party chat's being recorded.
It is. I just checked it.
What's up, Ian?
What's up, dude?
All right, so we are. All right, let's start.
Are you twitching right now or no?
Yeah.
Okay. Where's Twitch? That way I can watch it. Got a new job today.
Oh, nice. Where are you working?
For next generation marketing, and then I have another job offer from Legion, and
the FX series.
Yeah, the FX series.
No, I wish
the Geth that helps Shepard defeat the Reapers.
Right.
Oh wait, I mean spoilers for, you know, people that haven't seen Mass Effect
or who haven't played a 10-year-old game. Yeah. So
I think five years is good enough.
Yeah, no but shit.
The one for Legion is salary based, and the other one is hourly plus commission plus drive time and all that fun stuff.
Nice. Ooh.
Then if I do well, they said that within the first year they'll move me up to
assistant to the regional manager.
No, they'll move me up to the regional manager.
Yes, the office shout out. No, God, Josh, I love you.
They'll move me up to
false.
Fucking exactly. They'll move me up to account manager, and I'll be making six figures. So.
Nice.
So
nice.
Open.
And you can get all the tattoos that you want.
Exactly.
I need to get another tattoo.
Dude, I love my tattoos. I have one on my left shoulder. I'm a diehard Colts fan. So I have the horseshoe and then the anchor on my forearm, which is going to be a little oppressing here, but my wife and I had a miscarriage at the beginning of last year, and we were going to name our daughter Charlotte. And I actually found out after the fact that I got it, but Charlotte actually means anchor to your soul in Celtic. So I got a 4-inch by 4-inch anchor on my forearm. So, you know, it's just one of those things that just reminds me of, you know, my daughter just being perfect.
Yeah, a buddy of mine, his brother had one too this year, a miscarriage.
It sucks, man. You know, it's not one of those things.
There's nothing you can really say about it. Like, you know, it's one of those things where you can't really. It's hard to say something positive to the person that's had one.
Yeah, you know, that's one of the things too. Is, you know, like it wasn't really. You know, it was tough on our relationship from a standpoint of, you know, we were both just emotionally hurt and everything, but, you know, it wasn't like, you know, we were arguing about it or blaming each other or anything like that. So, I mean, it's cool. But, Ian, we were talking about EA and about how they fucked Titanfall by putting it next to Battlefield and COD.
Beat that one more time.
I said we were talking about EA and how they fucked Titanfall by putting it so close to Battlefield and COD.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll admit that, you know, it wasn't their best move and everything like that, but, you know, they're trying to push out first-person shooters and, you know, people are going to buy them regardless. And I just picked up a Sniper Elite 4. Sniper Elite 4. Sniper games come.
No, I was going to ask, did anyone pick up For Honor or Sniper Elite?
I played the beta. I wasn't really a fan of it. I just posted, as of today, I posted our For Honor Let's Play in tonight at midnight. It went live, so. But I played the beta. It wasn't for me. I don't really see too much replayability for it. I think it'll be great to play for a few weeks, and then after that, just kind of ugh, whatever.
It's one of those things where, you know, it's not bad, but yet it's not good. Graphically, it looks really, really good. Gameplay-wise, it's a little wonky for what it is. I mean, they had good intentions and everything like that. I think it kind of missed the ball. But I will admit that, you know, it's each character has so many moves that they can do and everything like that. But eventually, it's going to get extremely stale. You know, it's just the same
that's
repetitive
bullshit.
Nonsense.
I was
over
so
and over
far away
and over
from
again.
That fucking tick. God damn it. Fuck you.
I was going to say, too, isn't it kind of weird to think, but here we are in February, and could it be that it came out during a time that's about to get, you know, swamped? Like, you know, Sniper Elite 4 came out. Mass Effect's going to come out literally a month from now.
That's what I think, that it's just going to...
Ghost Recon, and then also Zelda is be first of March, like beginning of March, and then Horizon Zero Dawn.
What I mean, think is going to happen to it is it's just going to, the servers are going to boom until Mass Effect comes out, and then that's it, and then it's going to be game over for it. That's my feeling on it. But, you know, I've been known to be wrong. I'm very opinionated, and I gloat a lot when my opinions are right, and I'm about 95% sure that this is what's going to happen to it. It's going to boom for the first 3 weeks, and Horizon Zero Dawn's going to come out, and then you're going to get Mass Effect and Ghost Recon and stuff like that, and then it's going to be game over for it.
Oh, Daniel, I agree with you, but it's going to be sooner than Mass Effect before that game dies down.
Well, for me, that's you know, the optimist in me. I think after Ghost Recon comes out, that it's going to be fucked.
Yeah. I'd say even before that, I'm going to say by the time Horizon and Zelda come out.
When is that?
Horizon is, like, I think it's February 28th, and then Zelda is March 3rd.
There you go.
Because Zelda comes out on the day that the Nintendo Switch comes out.
And oh, the day right. that Logan comes out.
Yeah. I'm legit excited for that.
Movie. Yeah, you guys need to fight to the death on who's going to write the review for it.
I'll tell you what. Wait a minute, who wrote the last movie review? Or
You wrote John Wick.
I wrote John Wick.
And then I'll Ben's tell you doing what. Lego Batman.
I'm sure we can settle on it.
You guys can fight to the death. I know how to do it. One-on-one in Titanfall. Boom. Problem solved.
The arena.
That'll be kind of one-sided because, you know.
Could you suck at this game?
You still don't have it.
Yeah, my little brother traded it in by accident. Oh,
well. Yeah, he did.
What? Dude.
Yeah.
He thought it was the first one. I'm like, no, it's the second one. He goes, oh no, I'm sorry. I'm like, it's whatever. Did you at least get a good game out of it? Well, what did you get?
Ghostbusters.
Oh, he got those digital redeem cards and he spent them all on freaking Minecraft skins. I'm like, god damn it.
Oh, that's brutal.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie, my soul hurt just hearing that.
Yep. A little piece of Josh died there.
Yeah. Well, oh well.
Anytime anybody says Minecraft anything, I'm like, no.
I never got what the big deal was about Minecraft. I mean, yeah, it's cool for what it is, but I mean, it's kind of boring after a while.
Oh my god, I just almost killed a Legion with my nuclear eject. Right when he got into the Titan. I'm such an asshole. I'm that player, ladies and gentlemen. I am. I'm shameless. I'm like Frank Gallagher. Shameless.
Dude, I just started watching that.
Dude, that show is so ridiculous. Good. Where are you at? Dude,
I'm on the ninth episode of the first season.
Have you seen that, Josh, yet?
I haven't, but what cracks me up is, like, I have Showtime, and, like, I've known about it for, like, a while.
Oh, my God, what the hell is wrong with you?
No, but here's what cracks me up is, I can tell, like, it's funny hearing all the people that are just discovering it on Netflix.
It's so
when
good.
I'm like, Shameless? You mean the show that's been around for, like, 9 years?
Jesus, you're late to the fucking party. That's like being like,
I have Showtime.
Wait,
I have Showtime, and I am.
What? Yeah. Like, bro, it's 2017.
I've been meaning to watch it.
I will admit that the oldest daughter, the brunette. Yes, awesome. Oh my god.
Dude, it is like boobies galore in that show. It's a little ridiculous.
You know,
actually, my sister, started watching that show, and she watched like half of the first episode. She goes, "Oh, there's no nudity in that show," and she still stands by it to today that there's no nudity in that show.
There's full on dong in that show.
Yes, is she there crazy is like,
or is she given alternative?
She's bets? No, she's my like, she's my bigot Trump supporting sister, the one that denies like everything.
Yeah,
she's like the world's flat.
There was no nudity in Shameless. Believe me.
Yeah, there's no nudity in Shameless, and the world's flat.
As Sean Hannity, there's no Shameless. There's no nudity in Shameless.
Okay, and just like there's no sex in porn.
Yeah. No, there's only love.
But boom. Dude, freaking Fiona, man. Oh, I wish I could meet a girl like that.
Have you guys met?
Not just for the sex and stuff like that, but I mean just personality and, you know.
Josh, you want to gangbang like this dude over here?
Yeah.
Oh, where are you at? All right, I got the sword core.
There's so much homo going on right there.
Hell yeah, man.
Okay, for the record, we are not homophobic. We were just throwing it out there.
Yes, indeed. I got the Titan kill. And well, let's take this motherfucker down.
You know, have you guys watched another Showtime series, Californication?
Yes, another
I tried
great
to get into
fucking
that.
Show. I love that
I
show
tried to
so
get
much.
Into it.
It's so
like,
good.
I don't know. I never watched X-Files, like, because I was like, do Covenant start? But like, after watching that, I'm like, all right, I gotta see what else the guy has done. Like, that show was so good.
That show is so ridiculous. It's so good. It, apparently too, that's like a story about like it's based on his real life. So his life
the creator,
is really
yeah.
that crazy. I love the one where the fucking episode where his bald dude's going down on one girl, and he's like, oh, now I remember why I stopped dating her. Now I remember why.
She squirts.
Yeah.
Dude, I don't know how people can think that squirting is hot. Like, honestly.
Yeah, I don't really get it either.
I mean,
you got it. You got a comment on there?
No, it's just fucking weird.
I thought Josh had a comment on squirting on that. Wow, this conversation took an interesting turn.
Yes, it did. That's so weird. I don't know. I think he might have gotten disconnected. I'm gonna stop the matchmaking here. Let's check. No, he's still here. He probably just muted his mic. Josh, you're muted. He said his mic is down. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and hop into another game here then. Yeah, that's another show that you need to watch, Ian. Californication. That show is fucking ridiculous. That, you need to watch Star Wars Episode 7, man. You haven't seen The Force Awakens?
I'm
what the
back.
Hell is wrong with you?
I don't know.
Josh.
I'm busy, I've been stressed out.
Ian has not seen The Force Awakens. How the fuck does that happen?
Oh. Okay, first, but let's talk about squirting. No, I'm kidding. Anyways, no, but that's... You haven't seen The Force Awakens, man?
Nope, I haven't.
That was like...
What Star Wars fan are you? That was like so 2016, 2015, bruh.
Focus. Here's the thing, though, bro. I'm a purist. The only episodes that matter are 4, 5, and 6.
Oh, fuck off. Fuck off with that bullshit. I mean, I will admit that the first three movies are horrendous, and if you believe that those movies are good, just have a second thought and remember that you have self-respect. Those movies suck. Those movies are fucking horrible. Please, for the love
hold
of
on.
God, stop calling them good.
Hold Hold on a second there, Daniel.
No, stop. Was a great stop. Movie. No, you shut your whore mouth. That movie was horrendous.
Attack of the Clones.
Obi-Wan and Anakin. Are you kidding me? That was
okay.
Awesome
okay, I
watch.
Will. I will give you that the third movie is the best of the shit pile, but it's still a shit pile. Like, that's nothing to be out of. That's like saying that you polish a shit, and it's still a shit. Just because you polish a shit does not make it a diamond. Like, poop out of
shit. It's like putting lipstick on a pig. It's still a pig.
That's exactly what it is.
You're talking to a guy with a degree in marketing that can tell you that diamonds are worthless. So, I mean, a diamond is worth as much as a shit.
It's an expensive shit.
Cleon, come on, reload. Thank you. Yeah. Whoever just killed that dude just saved my fucking ass. But no, so I will give you that the third movie, Revenge of the Sith, is definitely in the eyes of a terrible movie. Yes, it's still a bad movie, but it is the best of the sequels or the prequels.
Let me say this for something, okay? The fight between Anakin and Obi-Wan, really fucking
good.
You
were the chosen one.
You admit that, right?
That was good. The one thing
I'm not done yet, dude. Okay.
All right.
So that's good. I love the execute order 66 scene because you're watching the death of the Jedi and just the beginning of the Empire. I love the beginning when they took down Count Dooku. And then
don't be talking shit about Count Dooku. Count Dooku is the shit. I'm only saying that just because it. I'm joking, dude. I was gonna say, because Christopher Lee, he might be old, but he's the only dude who's put out a metal album at his age, as well as he was fucking Dracula, as well as he was the judge in Sleepy Hollow, the one with Johnny Depp. Not a lot of people
fucking,
know that.
Fucking Ian is just like, but Count Dooku, man.
don't forget he was also Mr. Sender from the Stupids.
Oh, that's true.
He was also
Saruman.
Saruman. Yeah. Another great villain. Role.
Died after the cries in the world of Hobbit movies.
Itch, you have no idea how to use Ronin, do you? Oh, apparently he does. God damn it. Fuck you. Oh. No, I will say Attack of the Clones is the worst, one of the worst fucking movies that I have ever seen. God, the whole scene where they're going into the arena, they're like, I love you, or then, like, you know, they're having a picnic on the fucking... What kind of fucking Jedi goes and has a picnic? Are you serious?
Hey, apparently Anakin Skywalker does.
So, here's the thing.
Dumb.
Before there, Force Awakens
there
came
is
out,
no thing. That movie sucked.
My fiance and I, we watched them all, because she's never seen them before we went to Force Awakens.
Uh-huh.
And, I remember the only thing I remember, like, she could handle watching all of them, but once we got to Attack of the Clones, she was like, "Holy shit, is this movie still going?"
Yeah, that movie sucked.
Yeah, but you know what? Phantom Menace had Liam Neeson. Still, it's an all right movie, not great, but Phantom Menace.
The first one. Episode one.
Snap! I almost forgot that he played a Qui-Gon Jinn.
Yeah.
Who are you?
And then the fight scene between him, Obi-Wan, and Darth Maul. That's another fucking good one. You know,
that one was good.
Knock on the prequels all you want. They had superior Jedi battle scenes.
Yes. I will give you that. There was a meme that I saw on Reddit the other day, and it said it was Darth Maul, and it was somebody handing him a Hershey's bar and said halfsies. fucking Darth Maul. I don't know, man. I just think the villains were super fucking weak in those movies, and you know they're weak in the Marvel films too, except for Loki. I don't know. I'm just a grumpy old man.
Yeah, you're grumpy.
Fuck you, Josh.
You're not even at that old man status yet, dude. Once you have a kid and everything like that, that is when you can finally bitch about being an old man.
having the son that Josh doesn't have, apparently.
Because you're confusing me with a different Josh.
I know like five Joshes. You know, one of my favorite speaking of stupid shit, one of my favorite movie lines was from Harold and Kumar, and the guy's like, hey, he's like, it's like, well, what's your name? Oh, my name's Kumar. What the fuck, your name is Kumar? You got like five O's and two U's. I love that line.
Extreme.
Or don't do me like that, MPH. God, those movies are hilarious. Do you want a cock meat sandwich?
I think the second was the best one.
I second that notion.
Yeah. That third one, if you like, I went and saw it in theaters in 3D and shit. It looks so fucking silly to watch.
Fuck.
Now.
What? Harold and Kumar?
Yeah, the third one, the Christmas one.
Oh,
because, like,
yeah.
They filmed it because it was like when 3D was like all the rage. Like, they were doing every movie in 3D.
My Bloody Valentine 3D.
Oh, that stupid movie. Fuck.
It wasn't bad. It was just, it was awful. But
I like to call that Supernatural during the summer, because like one of my favorite shows is Supernatural, and
that's a great show.
Like that movie starred Dean from Supernatural, and like the same year Sam, the guy who played Sam, was doing the Friday the 13th reboot. Which, speaking of which, yeah, they're gonna reboot that if they ever fucking make it.
Oh God, please no.
What was that one with Colin Farrell that they? Oh, Fright Night. There we go.
That I like that one.
They reboot?
I'm really not much into horror films. Okay, guys, I was first on our team. That means something bad happened. If I'm first on our team in scores, that means that we did really bad. Because I'm not.
I mean,
really,
you're only
game.
Down by, you're only down by a few.
Yeah.
Advocate gift. We just lost two viewers. Of course we did, because we suck.
They probably didn't like our Star Wars talk. They're probably prequel lovers.
Hey, man, fuck you, man. The prequels were great, man. They're going to leave some sort of, like, hate review on it.
Fuck you guys, man. Midichlorians is where it's at.
some 12-year-old's going to go and fuck my mother now. Oh, Jesus.
Shit
is right. So, all right, I think I got one more game in me, and then I'm going to hop off.
Yeah, it's like almost 3:30 here.
Yeah, it's 1:20 here, and I got to be up at 6:30 to get to work.
It's 1:20 somewhere.
It's 4:20 somewhere. Light it up.
Oh.
So the thing that sucks about getting off work super late is I still have a ton of energy.
Yeah, I hate that.
And I have to be back at work at fucking noon tomorrow.
Ugh. Oof. Icky sticky poo poo.
The worst was my last job before the job I have now. I'd go into work at 6 in the morning and I'd work till like 10:30 at night.
Oh, fuck that.
And I'd go back the next day and then work a 6 to 2 and then be done for the week. Fucking brutal.
Yeah,
that's
no,
all I can say.
California would murder you for all for the labor laws. They would
no,
murder
like,
you.
It was
it a salary job?
No, it was a nursing job.
Oh, okay.
And I was in, you know, I did 16 hours and then turn around 8 hours off and then did another 8.
Well, that's nurse's life for you.
But you know what? That was I got paid 40 hours for, you know, 2 days of work, so.
Not bad.
What kind of man is nurse?
But yeah, I'm glad I'm no longer fucking doing that. I'll gladly take desk job over
nursing.
Over that any day. Yeah.
Oh, I'm sure you dealt with some like shitty people too. I always like hearing some shitty people stories from nurses.
They weren't shitty. It was just, you know, they had dementia, so I really couldn't say they're shitty.
Okay.
Some of them had shitty family members. I'll tell you that.
What's the worst one that you had?
All right. The worst one. Okay.
Oh, that's fucking bullshit. How the fuck did that happen? No. We're gonna talk about this shit here. I went to beat a guy down, and I was closer than him. And then he backs away, and he's farther away than I was, and he beats me down as he locks onto me. Fix your shit, respawn.
Wait, hold up, let's
God
see.
God damn it.
While we're on the subject, the worst one was,
mm-hmm.
Took care of a person that passed away, and their family didn't give him, like, a service.
Oh, that's
really,
fucked
that's
up.
A fucked up family.
Yeah. I saw too much of that shit.
Yeah, it just makes you, like, you know, be thankful for the family that you have.
Oh, I know. I'm gonna treat my future kids, the kids I don't have yet, Daniel.
Yeah. Oh, fuck you, man.
I'm a true.
It was
grade,
a long
so
day.
Way, they just don't ditch
me. Shit, man! If you keep on bullying me, I'm gonna drop the bane hammer on you.
Whatever, man. I'll resurrect like the Phoenix.
Fuck. And no, the worst one that I had was. The worst customer that I had was in San Francisco, and the guy locked me in his house because his fridge was not working. There's a lot of backstory to it, but long story short, I told the guy to... Yeah, long story short, I told the guy I needed to order some parts for his fridge, and he didn't turn off his fridge, and when that happens... And when all the refrigerant leaks out, it starts pumping oil from the compressor all the way through the refrigerant system.
Yeah, and he doesn't know that?
And,
oh, I know where this story's going. Okay.
And what happened was it's a $15,000 fridge. So I told the guy, I actually unplugged it before I left, told him to leave it unplugged, and we would come back and I would install it for him. And install the parts for him. Well, he did not unplug it. And so, of course, I go out there, and all the tubes are full of oil. And when that happens, your fridge is just toast. Like, it's just done, because all the copper that we have to replace is welded shut. It's welded inside of the cabinet. So the guy just goes off on us about how we wasted his time, how I wasted his money, and this is back when I had a union. Dude. This is back when I had a union to protect me. So I told him, you know what, man, fuck you. And he was like, excuse me? I said, you know, fuck you. You heard me. Are you fucking deaf? I was like, I left this unplugged. I told you to not to let this thing run, and you did not listen to me. So therefore, this is your fucking fault. So don't come crying to me about it. Basically is what I told him.
And
so he locked me in the house and told me, "Yo, you're gonna stay here and you're gonna fix it." And I said, "No, I'm not." Thankfully, I was with one of my friends, a coworker, and this coworker, shout out to Kirk, he's like 6'7", like 300 pounds, and he was just a big dude. And so the guy locks the door, and we ended up having to call the cops, and the cops came out. He refused to open the door, so they had the SWAT team come out, and they busted down the door. What? And they fucking, like, arrested him and everything. Yeah.
That's awesome. Karma's a bitch, ain't it?
Dude is probably gonna go Resident Evil 7 on your ass and fucking cook you up or whatever.
I know, man.
Dude, you're about to get turned into Ethan right there. You're about to be like the Baker family. Start feeding Daniel,
that was the worst
Daniel
one I had. I know
his arm
that
cut off, and then he pours water on it to heal himself.
beat Resident
that.
Evil
Magic.
7.
How'd you like
Evil
it?
7. It you can easily make it as long as you want. Like, if you just want to wander around and try to find every fucking thing, you can easily make it a 12-hour game. But if you want to breeze through it in less than 4 hours, you can definitely do that as well.
Nice. Yeah, I know Ben's writing the review for it, but you should write an opinion piece on it.
I'm going to. They definitely did it right with this one. They definitely saved the franchise with this game.
It was
what Resident Evil needed.
I'm not gonna lie. I'm kind of intimidated to keep playing through. Like, I just got...
Or where are you at in it?
I just got the shotgun.
Oh, so you put the replacement in the statue and all that?
Yeah.
You know that if you find the repair kit, you can repair that shotgun, and then if you go upstairs into the kid's room and then go up into the attic, and
boom,
you can find a wooden replica of the shotgun, and then go ahead and keep that.
Really?
Yes.
No, so, like, actually, like, I'm gonna have to, like, watch, like, a Let's Play or something on it, because I'm in the basement right now, and I'm just fucking stuck. I'm trying to figure out where to go.
What keys do you have? Do you have the snake key?
I have the scorpion key.
Okay, so you're gonna... Are you at the part where you have to find the cards?
I'm not sure.
Have you gone into the other house yet and fought the mom?
I haven't fought the mom yet.
Okay, so you're
I did the first battle with Jack. Yeah, was that Jack the patriarch of the family?
Yeah. So you got the shotgun. So then you're gonna have to. You have the scorpion?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're gonna have to, did you find all three heads
we're in the lead
for the door?
No.
Okay, so you're gonna have to find all three heads to the door. So, there's one down in the basement over in the, where you fought Jack. In the, And then there's gonna be one.
I think you're misunderstanding me. The only Jack boss battle I've done yet is the one where the cop leads you into the garage, and then Jack comes behind him. And...
Oh, okay. So, yeah, you're... Wait, you got the shotgun already? Damn.
Yeah, I looked at a Let's Play because I wandered down into the basement and I saw the fucking whatever those things are called. And I was like, the molded. I was like, fuck this. And I was running low on ammo.
Did you go into the morgue?
Yeah.
Okay, did you solve the puzzle for that?
No, I haven't.
Okay, so the puzzle for that, it's gonna say there's a red hand and two A's. So you're gonna open up the door of in the morgue that has the red hand on it, and then you're gonna go down to the all the way towards the end of the last chamber where it and it'll have the name with two A's in it. You're gonna open that up, and then it's gonna open the first one, and then you're gonna kill one of the bigger molded, and then you're gonna take the key so that way you can get into the dissection room. And then that'll continue on, so that way you can go ahead and fight Jack again and destroy his ass with a chainsaw. So much fun.
Do you, how many times do you fight each family member?
You fight Jack 3 times, you fight the mom once, and then you fight the son once, but he kind of puts you through, like, this sadistic freaking puzzle.
Maze, yeah, yeah.
The mom was fairly easy to beat.
All right, guys, I think we're going to go ahead and end this Let's Play here because I am exhausted. Right, it is time for me to go to bed. So you can find our stuff at supernovagames.net, all the stuff that Josh was talking about, our reviews and everything. Check out his review of John Wick 2. Great review, great movie. And we're going to go ahead and end this here. Peace out, guys.
Peace out.